Williams.
Mihai's looking worse. Thank God he has his granddaughters here to help him out. They're sisters, 15 and 10. Engaging the enemy in combat so we could use his physiological data to improve the drones had always taken a toll on Mihai's body. But today, he was really showing his age. The drones we based on his data were being taken down at a faster rate now compared to when the war began. When Mihai found that out, he insisted on flying to the front lines to see it for himself. Sometimes he could be so stubborn. His age wasn't the only thing affecting his health. Over the years, flying at high altitudes for prolonged stretches of time had ravaged and poisoned his body. But he was a man of grit. Today, after 28 years, he saw combat again. If his flight suit still wasn't good enough to protect him, I can't imagine how many G's he hit today during the battle. As a pilot, he exceeds all our expectations. It's going to take a bit more tweaking before our drones can match his skill.
How penal is this penal unit, you ask? This place is a shithole. If you took the stink of all the corruption in the world, then corralled it all in one place, that would give you a pretty good idea of what the air smells like around here. We got all kinds of critters, too. Everything from flea-ridden guards, rabid dogs, and a mechanic doing the stretch for life. I can't forget the rats. Yeah, we got those. And some pilots who got their wings clipped, too. One's a great pilot, but a lousy thief. One's a gambler with no luck. And one's an anarchist with no balls. Their job here was to rev the engines on the fake runways. The idea was for Aruja's spy satellite to pick up the heat sig. Even though there weren't any real fighters here, it looked like it on their infrared. I bet you're wondering, if Aruja lost the war, how come they still have a spy satellite? Because someone over there was smart enough to train a bunch of computer nerds to hack into half of Osea's satellites. That's how come. Every now and again, I'd try to bust out. And every single time, those damn dogs would drag me right back. When I was in my cell, I'd hear this voice coming from the guards room. It was the Aruzian princess rallying her people on the Aruzian national broadcast. All us prisoners had become big fans of hers. You want to hear something funny? The guards were big fans, too. I swear to God, every time she was on the air, they'd turn up the volume on the radio and sit there listening. I could see how someone like her could win the hearts and minds of soldiers and workers alike. When the princess said something, you could tell she meant every word. Lately, she'd been having more fun with her speeches, and that made her seem even more charming. You could say her charm was like a virus. Whenever she'd point out stuff that was wrong with Osea, the prisoners in here went nuts. Hell, if anyone knew how messed up Osea was, it was the prisoners. They'd shout, "Burn Osea down." No way am I just gonna sit here and rot away in this hellhole. Dark blue. Instead of building fake-ass planes to trick Aruja, I'm gonna build one that'll really take off. You can count on that.
As proved by the failure of our previous strategy, the Arsenal Birds have bolstered the enemy's anti-air network. This will be difficult to overcome. However, we still need to get swiftly to the space elevator no matter what it takes. Someone there is counting on us. The hero of the Circum-Pacific War and the man who spearheaded the construction of the space elevator. Osea's former president, Mr. Harling. Mr. Harling was inspecting the elevator when the war broke out. He's been classified as missing since the elevator was taken over by the Aruzian forces. However, a According to the latest intel, a military officer accompanying Mr. Harling hid him inside the facility. Both are waiting for a chance to escape. Enemy anti-air radar network has been set up around the space elevator. It's likely a large squadron would be detected. We will send a single aircraft through the network and send in a rescue team soon after. A number of anti-air radars have been set up around the space elevator. However, our reconnaissance suggests their network is weakest along the southeastern coast of Seletapura. So we can elude the enemy's observation. There are a lot of rain clouds this time of year. Flying through the clouds will enable us to stay hidden from their radar. If you happen to be detected by their radar, we will be forced to abort the mission. The lone pilot will head up this strategy as you, Trigger. After you bust through, secure the rescue craft's landing zone by taking out the anti-air weapons. Gollum and others will arrive shortly for support. Provide escort for Mr. Harling's craft after rendezvous. Good luck out there, everyone.
Aircraft preparations complete. Sortie ASAP.
Operation area, imposing radio silence. We'll radio you, but you are not permitted to make contact.
If you're spotted, the mission is over. Stay out of enemy radar. Use of weaponry is also strictly forbidden. Okay, you're heading up the Harling rescue mission. The success of this mission depends on you. Good luck. But stay focused. You can take up here. Just go with your gut. Don't worry, we're watching over you. Progress, Trigger. You're currently halfway to your rendezvous point. Look, I'm not gonna lie. It's just gonna be you and your radar out there. Just know, you got a bunch of people pulling for you. And I'm one of them.
Are we under attack? No change. Do we have bandits? Tell me the situation.
No problem. Stay alert.
Careful of ice formation in the clouds. You're 3/4 of the way. Been a long fight, but you're nearly home. Harling is still the president in my eyes. He ended the war, built the space elevator, and launched a spaceship from it. Despite his success, he remained a humble hero. I'll do my best to save him. Lend me a hand, Trigger.
What's happening? Give us orders. Increasing alert.
Rendezvous point dead ahead. Hang in there.
Thank you.
connection. Situation normal, nothing here.
Trigger, the first stage of the mission is clear. Don't celebrate yet. The real fight's about to get started. Radio silence is now lifted. The auxiliary craft will be arriving shortly. Destroy the anti-air around the space elevator. We're securing Sea Goblin's landing zone. Mage 2, target destroyed. Sights down. There are still AA guns. Destroy them and secure the LZ. Sea Goblin will arrive shortly. Eliminate hostile anti-air before then. Half of the anti-air guns down.
This is Sea Goblin. We've arrived. Do we have a clear LZ?
Mission still in progress. Stand by. Mage 2. Rescue team can't land until anti-air weapons are down. Destroy them. All anti-air guns destroyed. The landing zone is secure. Sea Goblin, you are clear to land.
Roger. Rendezvous point in sight. We're almost there.
Multiple bandits over Sela Tepura Harbor. Their container launched UAVs. Defenseless. Gollum and Mage, destroy all hostiles.
It's been a long journey, but you're on the home stretch.
Gargoyle will stand by near the space elevator.
This is Sea Goblin. Heading over to the X-Prez's location now. Run for the container!
Fox 2! Fox 2! Locked. The enemy has a lock on you, Mage 2.
Yeah, Mage 2 destroyed the target.
Target eliminated. Target is down.
Ambush! Fire from the far shore! They're targeting us! Get behind the chopper!
Eliminate all enemy UAVs. Don't let up.
Return fire!
UAVs approaching the space elevator. Stop them.
Taking fire! We're pinned down! Shoot back! X-Prez identified! Behind the gantry crane! Mr. Harley, stay right there! Jacob's been hit! Incoming rocket!
Sea Goblin, all survivors, respond! Is Mr. Harling alive?
You may be dead. We're fighting against machines. There's more!
That's about half. Mop up the rest.
Bandit is in my sights.
They got the chopper and Sierra too! That was so barbaric!
the space elevator. Shoot them down.
This is Colonel Johnson. Do you copy? I am with President Hurley. Rescue unit down, along with the soldier who had this radio. I'll get Mr. Hurley out of here.
Sir, we feel the same way. We'll figure something out.
You have even more than you think all of them.
Page 2, enemy has a radio. Control that Norwegian transport craft. Its engines are on.
I heard you were in the Air Force, Colonel. Can you fly?
Better than Mr. Hurley.
It'll do. Three remaining. All squadrons be advised. The call sign is Mother Goose 1. I've sent the information via the data link.
Mother Goose 1? That's the best you can come up with?
Missile! Break hard!
It's chow time.
Missile. One remaining.
Missile.
Target eliminated.
Good night. We'll pass out some exhaustion before the enemy wears out.
All UAVs have been splashed. All aircraft, former President Harling's transport is ready to take off. Mother Goose 1, take off. Let's wait till we're home safe. Mage Squadron, Mother Goose 1 is heading south. Provide support. 5 minutes remaining.
Skykeeper, bogey's on my radar. Bearing 220.
Sighting confirmed as MQ-101, forerunner for Arsenal Bird.
The big bird is coming, huh?
Mage, protect Mother Goose 1. Shoot down any UAVs. Gollum, intercept the UAVs.
Golem 1, Wilco. That last battle taught me a lot about those a-holes.
Golem 2, don't stray off on me. Always maintain element.
Wilco, forming up.
Radar lock acquired.
Fox.
Enemy UAV down. Keep up the good work.
Roger. Sending UAVs to the transport. Orders on a fire warning. Yes, sir. He's an old-timer. Has no clue how UAVs are used.
Mother Goose 1, UAV on your tail. Take evasive action.
I hear you. But this isn't exactly a fight.
Enemy UAV down. Great job, Trigger.
Understood. An Arsenal Bird is on its way. Strategic AI chose liberty over justice. Courses have already changed.
I'm spiked!
Gargoyle 1, where's the signal?
It didn't connect.
Gargoyle Squadron, stand by for my order.
Missile, it
may! Not the White House. I mean, the harbor. They won't be able to get home.
That ship isn't one of ours.
Nice work. Keep it up.
Where's the signal? Gargoyle, change radio frequency.
Gargoyle 1 here. We're about to leave the airspace. Keep your fingers crossed.
Gargoyle, it's time. Attention, Gargoyle Squadron. Babble, babble, babble.
Lock acquired. Gargoyle 3 to babble.
Babble, roger.
Assess the situation.
This is
Mage 1. I have Mother Goose 1 in my sight. Cabin's fine, but the cockpit's not looking so good.
Colonel Johnson, are you okay?
Don't worry about that. Just send help this way. I'm sorry. Get Mr. Harley. Please.
Mother Goose 1, respond. Mother Goose 1!
Skykeeper, should we continue providing cover for Mother Goose 1?
Of course. Mother Goose 1 is turning. What's going on? They're heading to the space elevator.
It's flying at a steady altitude. Who's in control?
It's not the Colonel. Mr. Harling's the only one on board. Mother Goose 1, respond! Mr. Harling, please respond!
We can't protect our objective if it sticks around here. Now's not the time to freak out, fellas. We've still got a job to do, so let's do it. Keep your mind focused.
Mr. Harling, we are not giving up on you. The UAVs are approaching Mother Goose 1.
Let's go, Trigger.
Take them down now, Mage Squadron. 1 minute remaining.
Lockdown hostile.
Mother Goose 1, turn 180 degrees and exit combat airspace. Mother Goose...
Mage 2! Mage 2!
Oh my god, Mother Goose 1 has been shot down.
Where'd the missile come from?
Mage 2 fired that.
It was Ocean. A friendly missile hit him.
Verifying the situation. Stop speculating.
Friendly fire! I saw it!
Mother Goose 1 exploded in air. No one could have survived.
Looks like it tried to protect the elevator. Erosian bastards, they just killed a hero!
Mage 1, was it Trigger? Trigger was the closest. UAVs were crawling all over our objective.
I told you to keep a goddamn eye on the hatchling. It must have been a mistake.
Arsenal Bird is entering. All aircraft withdraw immediately. Trigger, you can't fly for a while. You understand?
The operation to rescue former President Harling has failed. Sadly, there is no hope he survived. Trigger, you are suspected of assassinating the former president. There will be an inquiry. There will most probably be a court-martial.